Ready to learn an easy technique for dealing with triangles? In the quick corner method, only squares are used when making this block. In this video, you'll learn all the secrets behind making these quick corners in this bow tie block. To get started, you'll want to download these free patterns at learnhowtoquilt.com under the Saturday Sampler class. Cut 4 3.5-inch squares, 2 of the bow tie fabric and 2 of the background fabric. You'll also need to cut 2 2.5-inch squares of bow tie fabric or a matching fabric. On the wrong side of the 2.5-inch square, make sure you draw a diagonal. And that diagonal needs to go exactly from corner to corner. If you get off a little, make sure you go back and correct it. Take the background fabric and the small squares and put right sides together. Make sure your diagonal isn't in this corner, but that it runs in this direction. Pin and then sew on that line. After sewing, you want to press to the corner. You have the option of keeping this excess in, or you can trim it before pressing. I usually like to trim this because it's a lot of bulk. Lay out your block. Put right sides together, stack the sections, take it over to your sewing machine and sew a 1/4-inch seam. After sewing, press your seams in opposite directions and then lay out your block. Put right sides together to match that intersection. Pull back the seam and those seams should butt up against each other. Make sure that everything's lined up and pin. Here's my completed block. Now that you know how to make these quick corners, you have the skills necessary to construct more difficult looking blocks or quilt tops, like these star blocks or this 4-star quilt, or make some more bow tie blocks for a quilt. You can get many different designs from just 4 blocks. By the way, if you're worried about wasting all those clipped triangles, we have a video on recycling those along with the pattern using those recycled sets. Ready for more quick corner projects? In our next video, you'll get to use this quick corner method to make this jar. By now, you should have over 6 blocks for your sampler quilt. Thank you for visiting learnhowtoquilt.com. Please share our series with your friends.